I understand you're here to look at the regeneration of Liverpool. This is a great place to start off. Liverpool's been regenerating itself probably since the 1980s. So important regeneration, and we'll see evidence of that from the 1980s. But then as well in the noughties, between 2004 and 2008. They're probably the main periods that I'll kind of look at today. But I think to understand how Liverpool has regenerated, it's probably interesting to also find a bit about how Liverpool developed. Because Liverpool's a very interesting and important trade city and a port. But its history, to kind of go back a bit further beyond that, is interesting as well. So the area that we're in now, as well as being an area of recent development, has also got a lot of history. Liverpool started out as a fishing village on the banks of the River Mersey, pretty much in the location of the area that we're in now, because Liverpool, the pool in the name Liverpool, comes from a natural tidal inlet that used to exist just here where we're standing. So if you imagine this space in between these buildings and where the trees are there, this was a natural harbour, and the fishing village that Liverpool started off as kind of settled around there. We fast forward a few centuries to 13th century. King John came to Liverpool and he started a base here and developed Liverpool into a town by selling off plots of land to encourage people to come and stay here. So we mark Liverpool's history from 1207, which was the year that King John came here and started developing the town. Now the town very slowly grew with people trading to Europe around coastal Britain until the 1600s, when ships started going across the Atlantic, and that was quite a turning point. That Atlantic trade was lucrative, and the men and the merchants who were involved in that decided to invest in developing Liverpool as a port. Now what they did was they took the natural harbour, an inlet that I mentioned that was here, and they turned it into a dock. So they excavated the bedrock, built walls up on either side, and put dock gates and created a dock. It was Liverpool's first dock, and it opened up in 1715. Now it was not only Liverpool's first dock, but it was the world's first dock in the world, which is quite a significant point. And that was one of the reasons why Liverpool in 2004 got UNESCO World Heritage status. And this dark hole peaks down to that very first dock that was built in 1715. And if you imagine the size of it, again, if you look at the space that's created between these two buildings here that you can see, the Hilton Hotel and those apartments, imagine this whole area as a dock. You could have fit 100 ships in it when it was built. And it was really important in kind of turning Liverpool into a very significant port. Liverpool, due to its location in the UK, has always meant that it's been the port that's been used for trade with America. It started off trading with America, and it's still the main port for trade between the UK and America now. So this area that we're in now is called Liverpool One, and this is one of the more recent areas of the city to have been developed. In 2008, Liverpool was a European Capital of Culture, and in 2004 we were awarded that title. We had 4 years to prepare for it. The city worked very hard then, attracting inward investment to develop the city. And this area, Liverpool One, is really one of the legacies of that Capital of Culture era. It took a very underused part of the city, developed it into a 42-acre retail and leisure development. So we have all the kind of main high street shops that you'll see in kind of most places, the largest John Lewis outside of London in the country. So we've now got kind of the fifth best shopping offer in the country. We didn't have great shops before. People would travel to Manchester or Chester, but now, as well as the cultural offer and the heritage offer that the city has, we've got kind of shopping to balance that out as well. So before this whole development was built, this opened up in January 2009. Before they could build it, they undertook an archaeological excavation of this old dock, which was beneath it. They knew it was there, they'd never had the chance really to have a look at it. So they were able to excavate 80% of it. So as I said, it's all this area, so you can imagine how big it was. And then they carefully covered it up so that they could develop on top of it. And they left about 20% that's still unearthed. And the Liverpool Maritime Museum does tours down to see that old dock which sits underneath this development. So you've really kind of got the very beginning of Liverpool's development right underneath one of its major, more recent developments. So we're going to be walking in a big loop to have a look at a couple of Liverpool's oldest buildings, areas that have regenerated recently, such as Liverpool 1 and the 80s. And we're going to find ourselves at the end over in the Albert Dock.